everyone. This is Kruti Jaivanjoli, Assistant Professor in LGA Institute of Engineering and Technology in Department of Electronics and Communication. This video is about subject Digital Image and Video Processing. So friends, we are going to discuss regarding the video processing. In the last video, we learned about the video encoder, video decoding, how it can be possible. In this video, you are going to learn regarding the video codec description, video architecture, introduction to the standards MPEG and the H.226X. So these are the things that we are going to cover in this video. So friends, the particularly about the video codec description. The meaning of the codec, that is the coder decoder. So video encoder that is implemented, which requires the YUV 4Gen 2Gen 0 non-interface video input. And therefore, the pre-processing of the video input that may be required. And that depends on the application. So for the video decoder, post-processing that is needed to convert the decoded YUV 4Gen 2Gen 0 data to RGB for display. In the practical, we have also learned about it, that how can we convert the RGB to the other models and other models to the RGB. So the conversion of this into the RGB, that is required. What are the features? First is the pre-processing. What is the pre-processing? So YUV 4Gen 2Gen 2 interlaced, here the value of the Y luminance, that is the 4, U value is 2 and V value is 2, that is why it is the 4Gen 2Gen 2 interlaced from the camera, for example. Now YUV 4Gen 2Gen 0 non-interlaced, only decimation and no filtering of the UV component, that is required. So this is the first step. Now in the second step, the post-processing. YUV 4Gen 2Gen 0 to RGB conversion, that is the post-processing. Display format of 16 bits or the 12 bits RGB. 0 to 90 degree rotation for landscape and the portrait display, that is required. Now in the third one, that is the MPEG 4 simple profile, level 0, level 1 and level 2, which supports the another one, that is the H.263 and MPEG 4 decoder and encoder complement. Next feature, that is the MPEG 4 video decoder options, that are AC-DC prediction, reversible variable length coding, that is the RVLC that is used, resynchronization marker RM that is required, data partitioning, error contrast element, proprietary technique, and the motion vectors for macro block, that is the 4MV. And unrestricted motion compensation decode VOS layers. So these are the things that is required for the MPEG 4 video decoder options. Now the next one is the MPEG 4 video encoder options. So these video encoder options that are, the first one, that is a reversible variable length encoding, RLVC. Now the resynchronization marker, that is the RM, motion vectors for macro block, header extension codec, bitrate target change during the encoding, coding of frame rate change during the encoding, and the insertion or the not of the visual object sequence start code. So these all are the things that is mandatory for the MPEG 4. Now the insertion of the iframe, that is during the encoding of the sequence support, is required. Encoder adaptive intra refresh support is required, and the multi codec support, multiple codec running from the same code, that is required. Now the video architecture. In that, the first one, that is the pixel representation. What is it? So the red, green, blue, that is the RGB, are the primary colors for the computer display. And the color depth that supported by the program up to 16 bits per pixel. So RGB 565, any combination again you can take. So RGB 565 mean the 5 bits for red, 6 bits for green and 5 bits for the blue. Now, in the consumer video, such that the DVD, camera, digital TV and others, the common color coding scheme is the YCB-CR, where Y is what? It's a luminance. CB is the blue chrominance and the CR, that is the red chrominance. So, this way, the human eyes, which are more sensitive to the Y component of the video, and that is why this enables the video subsampling to reduce the chrominance component without being detected by the human eye. This method is referred to as a YCB-CR, that is 4Gen 2Gen 0, YCB-CR 4Gen 2Gen 2, or YCB-CR 4Gen 4Gen 4. Now next is introduction to video coding standards MPEG and H.26H. What is the JPG that you know? It's a joint photographic experts group. Similarly, for the videos, the moving picture experts group work. So that is the full form of the MPEG, which was established in the year 1988 in the framework of the joint venture by the ISO and IEC Technical Committee on the Information Technology, with the mandate to develop the standards for the coded representation of moving pictures, associated video and their combination, when used for the storage and the retrieval on digital storage media with a bitrate up to about 1.5 megabits per second. So this is the introduction for the MPEG. Now, the MPEG, in that the various standards are there. The MPEG 1, MPEG 2, 3, 4. Okay, the 4 one, that's the latest one. So the MPEG 2 standard was released in the year 1994, and the standard was nicked MPEG 1 and it was issued in the year 1992. Okay, so the scope of the group was later extended to provide the appropriate MPEG 2 video and associated video compressions for a wide range of the audiovisual applications at substantially the higher bitrate not successfully covered and envisaged by the MPEG 1 standard. So that is why the MPEG 2, that is developed. MPEG 2 was given the character to provide the video quality not lower than the NTSC ALLPAR and up to CCIR 601 quality, with the bitrates targeted between the 2 to 10 megabits per second. Every emerging application such as the digital cable, television distribution, network database services via the ATM, digital DTR applications and the satellite and the terrestrial digital broadcasting distribution were seen to benefit from the increased quality supported, expected to result from the emerging MPEG 2 standard. the MPEG 1 and MPEG 2 video compression technique developed and standardized by the MPEG group have developed into important and successful video coding standards worldwide. With an increasing number of the MPEG 1, MPEG 2, VLSI chips, sets and producers to become the available on the market. So, the support with the wide range of the applications profiles or diversity of input parameters including the flexible picture size and the frame rate can be specifically designed. The key factor for the success in the generic structure of the MPEG standard supporting a wide range of the applications and application specific parameters. So, the another important factor that is MPEG group did only standardize the decoder structure and bitstream format. So, these are the three only with available with this. So, in the MPEG standard developed in the year 1991, ISO and IEC committee number is 11172. So, what are the specifications? Target bit rate around the 1.5 Mbps. Typical image format is CIF. No interlace. Frame rate is 24 up to 30 fps. Main applications that are the video storage for the multimedia. For example, on the CD-ROM. This is for the MPEG 1. MPEG 4 developed in the year 1999. ISO IEC 14496. What it will do? Object-based coding. Wide range of application with choices of interactivity, scalability and the error resilience, etc. So, this is about the MPEG 4. So, this is regarding everything related to the video processing. So, keep watching LGIET Electronics and Communication for more updates related to the digital image and video processing. Thank you very much, everyone.